Tony, Chase tonight, Blade tomorrow, TBA on Saturday. Just your thinking and Coach Anderson's thinking kind of with that plan going into the weekend.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of things went into that. Anytime you come upon these Thursday games like we did last week, it's going to kind of cause potential to shake things up anyway. Garrett Crochet was in the stadium tonight, which it was great to see him. And last time we played Georgia, we got pushed into a Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and he started on Thursday. It was his first start in a while. So Vanderbilt did it last week, I believe, with Christian Little starting against Georgia with a different setup. So, for us, again, a lot of different reasons, but we got our two freshest guys starting. And by no means, you saw how we approached the game. I mean, we started the guy we felt best to start. We brought in our best weapon out of the bullpen stuff-wise, and then we went to our closer immediately or early, if you want to call it that. So it's not as if we're conceding anything at all, but I think the best thing for us to do this particular weekend is to throw our two most fresh guys. And it's the one weekend you guys were kept bringing up, like, oh, you got this big problem that's coming around the bend. Well, this is the first weekend we've had four healthy guys that are the guys you all have talked about. And next week it'll take care of itself because we go to Hoover after. So there's four starts. They'll each get one. Which day it is, I don't know. But, you know, we liked our plan going into this weekend. It's easy to say that now because we won one game. But now it's time to turn to tomorrow, which I know they're geared up with their big dog tomorrow. I believe Blade and him pitched against each other last year, and they'll do it again.
Was part of it just looking to manage some innings on Burns and Beam as you kind of move into June a couple weeks?
Yeah, I mean, I think if you look at the way we've approached guys at the beginning, it's not like we baby guys at all, but I think, you know, Frank and I see eye to eye, and the one thing we don't ever want to do is run guys into the ground at any point. And, you know, when you got younger guys like Blade Tidwell last year, basically senior year gets erased due to COVID, and now all of a sudden he's thrown into a weekend starting role and he's, hey, throw 100 innings for us, even though, you know, he barely threw it all last year. I think you got to take some of that stuff into consideration. So the one thing too, again, the laundry list of things we get into, I think for us to be ready in any situation, it helps if those guys at least know what it looks like at least once to come out of the bullpen. So for all practical purposes, to me, our guys need to think we're in playoff mode right now. And I know the team we faced last weekend, Kentucky, was in that mode. And Harney was their Saturday game three starter. And what did he do when they were up in game two? That dude's a warrior, man. I'm sure they wanted him to go down there, but I know he wanted to go down there too. He runs down there and gets ready to finish the game.
How do you think Burns responded to coming out of the bullpen?
I thought he was great. I mean, you could maybe pick up on maybe sometimes when guys come out of the pen versus starting, there's a little less, off the throttle type approach and the heightened sense of intensity. Really, each inning is worth, I mean, Billy Beane's got a good, paragraph or two on that in Moneyball. Whether it's the ninth inning or whatever, they're all this, you need three outs in each inning. And, it's up to these guys to know what their personality is. But from what I saw, it was outstanding. And then, really, he's got a guy 0-2, and he just made one poor pitch. And if you take that away, you know, he might be the guy that finishes the game. Who knows? Although, you know, we're good going to Redmond.
Seventh. What was the conversation around that? Was there any conversation about sending him out for another inning?
Yeah, when I can tell, I kind of usually hide. I mean, we went out there. Burns can get himself out of that situation. Look what he did against Auburn. So I kind of ducked my head when I went out there and made a comment to him. But with Doe, I just hid. But if you did look at the sixth inning, he kind of had to gut through that deal a little bit. Now, pitch count-wise, he wasn't that deep in. But, again, same situation. The guy's coming off a two-week layoff. He's fresh, so you would think, well, he should be able to go. Well, the trips up and down are a little bit different, and me and Frank talked before. We didn't see any need again to run him into the ground. Like, let's get 100 pitches out of him. Now I think he can do that. Blade, I think, is at a position now where he can get 100. Beamer and Burnsy can do that as well. And then, you know, we're creeping up on a situation, too, where all four guys can say, hey, you need me out of the pen to get some outs like Kentucky did against us or other situations you can bring up, then I'll go do it. It's been fun. It maybe hasn't happened as often as it should be. And it's kind of like the pitching thing. Maybe you take Doe out earlier because you're like, man, maybe this guy fresh or whatever. It's nice to have some options. It's not like we're the deepest team in the country, but you've got some options. The trade-off there is maybe some guys lose out on reps that they'd like to have. And, you know, Coach Elander's the guy that pounded his fist on the desk early in the year and said, Blake Burke needs to have this many at-bats. And he doesn't do that often, so you know he's got some conviction to him if he says that. And you start looking at the stat sheet, and it's like, uh-oh. You know, you don't want that. I'm obviously a lot skinnier than he is. I don't want that guy mad at me. So let's get him out there. And the kid can hit. I've said that a million times to the media. So if anything, I do recognize that. But it's important for these young guys to get reps so they can kind of settle in a little bit or not try so hard. And I think that's what you've seen the last two times out is him just, you know, it's deep in the year now, man. There's no point in overthinking it or even looking at your numbers because they're only going to change so much. You just play ball when you get an opportunity, and he certainly did that and did a great job of it tonight.
Bunting has been something that's been an issue, it seems like, throughout the season. Just how frustrated are you with that aspect of the game?
Well, I mean, I think in general I'd like to go back. I think we've done well in a couple situations too. And then speaking of last weekend, I think Kentucky failed to get one down against us, or there was one recent. Normally if you ask a guy to get it done in the fourth or fifth, no problem in the SEC. Gets closer to the end of the game and some guys get sped up a little bit. Now, in this particular instance, you know, this evening, long story short, I just kind of screwed up the whole thing. He's one of our best bunters, but a miscommunication there. I think if we handle the three pitches that he saw a little differently, he gets it down. But again, the key is whether you're looking to move a runner or bunt a guy over or, you know, just put the ball in play, or even if you need a two-out hit, late in the game, it's all about playing baseball and not getting, you know, the theory with Big Poppy is he's the most clutch guy ever, but the other theory is the guy's just a really good player. And when the money's on the line, he doesn't change who he is or worry about what if this, what if that, or get all too amped up. He's just the same guy. So he had a lot of home runs in the first and second inning in his career, I'm willing to bet. And then, you know, equally effective in the eighth and ninth. Just got to be careful you don't get wrapped up in Ozark material.
My bad. When Dolander was hurt, you said you felt like him having some time off in the end may be a good thing. Now that it's been back a week and a half, do you feel like that's the case?
Yeah, and a lot of this too, guys, is these guys are kids and they're young and they're fresh of mind, fresh of body. They want to just go play. But you get up in the office, and again, late in the year, you got to be careful about not overanalyzing things. I think at the end of the year, you just want to look back and say, you know, like Hundley, kind of there at a couple points late in the year, we didn't use him when maybe we should have. And I'm not so sure I don't regret one of them, but you also don't want to look at it like, man, I don't know about this guy's career in pro ball because, you know, we just rode him, you know, like a rented mule. And I don't know, maybe Hundley owes us a little NIL dollars or me NIL dollars because he's throwing, I think, 93, 94 now, and he's only got one walk. He's over there at Smokey's Park, so maybe he can come over and watch us tomorrow.
That's all, Coach. That's time for. Thank you, guys. Thank